Hi, I'm Jessie Janae, and you're watching Shipping Things. And today we're shipping things with inner bags. What's an inner bag? I'm glad you asked. An inner bag is a cozy piece of packaging that hugs your product. So it actually has something to go in before it goes into its outer packaging, like a poly mailer or a shipping box. What are the different types of inner bags and why would you use them? That's what we're about to get into. So, you might be asking yourself, do I need an inner bag? When do I need an inner bag? And will an inner bag help me heal my inner self? And the answers are, maybe, I'll tell you, and unfortunately, probably not. Inner bags are great for packing up your items right off the production line. You want to take that item and get it into a bag right away. Why? Because manufacturing facilities and warehouses can be dusty, folks. And you want to keep your items in ship shape so they arrive to your customers perfect. And a bag can be just the way to do it. Because now, this item is safe. But more than that, I can also use it for organization. Because I can label this bag or just take this and sort it into different areas so I make sure I always know what inventory I have on hand. Having that extra layer around your soft goods keeps them organized and protected from the elements, which can be super helpful during transit. Because think about it, let's say you have a book and it's inside something like this, and then this package gets rained on. Well, you don't want rain going straight from the outside all the way to your book. So if it's in an inner package or inner bag, it's protected. But same goes for keeping liquids inside. Let's say you're shipping a spray or something liquid. Putting that puppy inside a bag means that liquid can't spill out onto other items in your box or actually to the box itself to make it soggy. Peace of mind in keeping your items actually arriving to your destination intact is the name of the game. But inner bags aren't just for protection and organization. They can also look nice. So let's dig into that. Now let's talk materials. How do we want our bag to look? It certainly doesn't need to look boring. You could use materials like clear plastic, bubble, or even fabric to achieve a wide variety of looks. And also think about your closure. Do you want it to zip so customers can open and close it again? Or use a drawstring? Or maybe a permanent peel and seal so that customers actually have to cut or open the bag to get your product. Other thing to consider, do you want your bag to be something that people might keep around as opposed to throwing in the trash or recycling? Then think about how they reuse it. This makes a great travel makeup bag. This here could be used to take shoes on trips or actually store things in a closet as well. And then this, I think I'd use this to store my POG collection. But either way, I'm certainly keeping all of them. As you've seen, inner bags can be super functional. But it doesn't mean they can't be a part of an awesome branded packaging experience. They could be a certain color that goes with the rest of your packaging, or they could be printed with a logo or a pattern or extra product information. Now, I know I told you that inner bags aren't the way to heal your inner self, but it just occurred to me that if your inner self would be really healed and pleased with excellent packaging at fulfillment and clean products arriving to your customers, they might just do a bang-up job.